Imagine the most alien environment you can. There's plenty to choose from. Exoplanets that rain molten glass and lead is always a liquid. Or if you will, a planet festooned with forests of foliage, stretching far taller in lower gravity than the trees of Earth, but with canopies colored black instead of green to take advantage of the light of a red dwarf star. Or how about a world dominated by a formerly biological, now machine civilization, with no traces of its planet's once garden-like existence left, removed in favor of efficient computation and the preservation of electronics? Maybe they even removed the oxygen that once drove their biology in favor of no oxidation. Once you've envisioned that, multiply it by a factor of 10. All of these scenarios involve a normal star, but here, all is not exactly normal. One of the strangest and most alien and dangerous environments in the universe is that of the environs of a neutron star. These collapsed remnants of once giant stars create one of the most alien environments possible in comparison to our comfortable Earth. Neutron star systems couldn't be more different from that of our solar system. Ultra-dense objects on the order of 1.5 times the mass of the Sun collapsed into a sphere, only about 20 kilometers in diameter. They represent among the densest states that degenerate matter can get under normal circumstances before collapsing further into a black hole. But with varying properties that class them as types of neutron stars, pulsars, magnetars, and more. A neutron star is born when the core of a giant star between a total mass of between 10 and 29 solar masses collapses after much of the star's material is blown out into space in a supernova. Even with the loss of that mass, the core continues to collapse until it reaches some kind of equilibrium. In this case, a neutron star is held up by neutron degeneracy pressure, which, if ever overcome, results in a black hole. Neutron stars themselves are bizarre objects, more akin in some ways to black holes than they are to normal stars and planets. For example, getting too near a neutron star results in spaghettification, like a black hole, where matter is torn apart into a stream of individual atoms. Also with neutron stars, due to their enormous gravity, you see gravitational lensing on a massive scale. If you were looking at a neutron star, parts of its far side would be visible to you in much the same way as if you were to look at North America from space but be able to see Mongolia on the periphery. Neutron stars can be very strange indeed, and eventually there will be one passing by in our general neighborhood, but not close enough to be a problem. It's known as RxJ185635-3754, and it's heading in our direction at very high speed. It used to be a star, then it went supernova, and actually would have been visible as such about 1 million years ago, which human ancestor species might have noticed at the time, or not. It's the closest neutron star yet discovered, at just 200 light years away. When it makes its closest pass to Earth, it will only do so at about 170 light years, in about 300,000 years. Interestingly, if we still exist by then, as a highly advanced technological civilization, this may well be the first neutron star we ever directly visit. 300,000 years is a long time for technological development and the expansion of humanity into the galaxy. On the science side of things, this neutron star is interesting not for just its proximity, but that it has no companion. It's isolated, which is allowing scientists to study how neutron stars cool off after a supernova event. But it might not always have been isolated, and we might even know what its former companion star is. In this case, the neutron star's movement and direction are known, and they match up with a hot blue star known as Zeta Ophicae, which is moving from the same region in a different direction, and they seem to have once been in the same location. The supernova of the neutron star would have separated the two and sent them in different directions. This neutron star was first detected in X-ray, but it has since been observed by Hubble. It's emitting a blue color, which means it's very hot, to the tune of a million degrees, as to be expected from a neutron star that was recently formed in a supernova. The neutron star is also creating a detectable bow shock as it moves through the interstellar medium. Close neutron stars aside, there is also a neutron star currently violating current theories we have on these objects. This one is known as GPM J1839-10, and it appears to be an ultra-long period magnetar, which is a young neutron star. They appear to be born with very strong magnetic fields. Located about 15,000 light years away, this neutron star has an odd history. It was first detected in 1988, but went unnoticed because its behavior was just too strange. Scientists didn't know to look for it because it was outside of the parameters of what was expected. So here's what's going on with this neutron star. So there's a limit, so far as we understand physically, where they should stop emissions. This is called the death line, where the rotation of the neutron star becomes too slow for detection as we know it. So with this particular neutron star, it's weird. Normally you'd think of neutron stars as rapidly rotating objects, sometimes shooting out rapidly repeating beams as a pulsar. The whole idea is that they rotate fast, like blink of an eye fast. Yet this one doesn't. It rotates at a rate of once every 22 minutes, which is outright glacial for one of these stars. And it emits bursts of radio that can sustain for up to 5 minutes. So far, there isn't an analog of this type of neutron star known, and it's unsure how it could be doing this. I've never seen any speculation on a technosignature here. It's unclear how it could be one. But it's one of those incidents in astronomy that don't really make sense physically based on what we know. But it's also equally unclear how it could be useful to make a neutron star do this, or how you'd make it do it. It's just one of those mysteries. There are many. Astronomy is littered with oddball detections that no further work has been done on because they don't quite fit the models. But as with anything, it may end up being a class of neutron star that we just don't currently understand. And we'll only know once we get more than a sampling of a single example. But back to the question of alien environments and life. The first exoplanets ever discovered were around a neutron star, Pulsar B1257+12. It has three planets, but those, however, are not good candidates for life. They are some of the most hostile planets we know of, to the point that the scientists named one of them Poltergeist. But there's a question here. Can there be circumstances where a habitable planet might exist around a neutron star? The answer is perhaps surprising. Yes. It turns out even neutron stars can have habitable zones, but there are key criteria for this possibility, and it very likely doesn't happen very often. The first is that it has to be a super-Earth with a very thick, shielding atmosphere. Anything smaller would lose its atmosphere quickly in that environment. This atmosphere would be more like the deep ocean on Earth rather than a proper atmosphere, in that it would need to be on the order of a million times thicker than Earth. Researchers at Leiden University studied the Pulsar B1257+2 system. Two of the three known planets are super-Earths, about five times as massive as our planet. At the orbits that they are at, they would receive enough heat for liquid water to exist, so long as they have those very thick atmospheres. But there's a huge question here. Any planets that might have existed before the supernova that left the neutron star would have had to weather that event intact, which is unlikely. Alternatively, however, a captured exoplanet may have better chances. But the strangest part in all of this is the possibility of life on a neutron star itself. This is a very old idea, originating with the venerable late Frank Drake of SETI fame. It's not entirely clear what really happens with neutron stars. We know that their dense cores should be made up entirely of degenerate matter, neutrons crushed together. But the upper layers of the neutron star could see something very different and exotic. It may be that the outermost layer of a neutron star is made up of matter that can exist nowhere else in the universe. It's unclear what this exotic matter might look like, but it can be considered that it might also be capable of exotic nuclear chemistry on or near the surface of the neutron star that might be very complex and even allow for life as we do not know it to exist. This idea was expanded upon by sci-fi author and scientist Dr. Robert Forward, where he speculated that anything living on the surface of a neutron star would need to essentially be flat and astonishingly dense to hold up. They would also live in fast forward, because nuclear chemical reactions are far faster than normal chemical ones. So any such creature would have a life cycle millions of times faster than anything on Earth. And they'd have a rough life. If their few minutes of existence happened at the wrong time, such as during a shift in the neutron star's crust, an earthquake does not do justice to a starquake, which would be orders of magnitude worse than what Earth's crust can produce. They'd also be limited in their movement because their nuclear molecules would be electrically charged, moving in a gigantic magnetic field. Straightforward motion would not be possible. Rather, they'd move more like a sailboat does, tacking sideways. At the same time, however, this is highly speculative because we know so little about neutron star surfaces, and even less about nuclear chemistry and how that could create some kind of life very different from anything else we've ever envisioned. We're also incredibly unlikely to ever know if this kind of life can exist. You can study a neutron star from afar, but you can't get close enough to look for signs of life. But it does add one more possibility, if remote and speculative, to the mix as far as existence in this universe. To take it a step further, however, one can wonder that if life on the surface of a neutron star is possible, can intelligence arise on one? And if so, it would be so exotic that it wouldn't be able to leave the neutron star and would be locked in, forever weathering one of the harshest environments possible, living in fast forward, thinking a million times faster than we do. I think I'm rather glad to be made of normal matter and living comfortably here on Earth as opposed to a neutron star. Thanks for listening. I'm futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently addressing the perplexed that are wondering why I'm releasing so many videos lately. The answer is simple. I'm extra heavy on material to cover right now. Usually, once I have a script, which the research is the time-consuming part, it takes one day to produce these videos from recording to uploading and releasing. Well, over the last year, I've accumulated ideas and scripts, and they're overflowing. There are like over 40 of them accumulated, and that's not counting the spooky October scripts, which are forming up nicely. So I'm doing a sort of end-of-year clearinghouse with rapid-fire videos. At the start of the new year, I'll likely slow back down to 2 videos and an Event Horizon interview per week. And don't worry, I won't burn out. Making these videos is fun. I enjoy the whole process, from conceiving the video to releasing it and chit-chatting afterwards with folks in the comments. It's a blast. And after 7 years of doing it, it's as fun as it ever was, and I'll be doing this for centuries. And when January comes, it will be time to put the finishing touches on the next book. Oh yes, there's a new one in the works. And it's tentatively entitled The Necrosignature. And that's all I'll say about that. And be sure to check out my previous books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.